am Tarun Kumara, class plus 1B of Government Model Senior Secondary School, and my registration number is S5GMSSS under the sub-theme Mathematical Modeling. I have made my project on the topic Sine of Trigonometric Ratios. As we know that this time the theme of the exhibition is technology and toys. So I try to relate my project by making road tracks with beautiful LED lights showing how sines of T ratios changes in different quadrants. Now let us explain the model. Here you can see that I have made four quadrants. Quadrant number first, this quadrant number second, quadrant number third and quadrant number fourth. So I have fixed all the LED lights in all the four quadrants and I have named the LED light as sine theta, cos theta, cosecant theta, sec theta, tan theta and cot theta. That these all are the 60 ratios of the quadrant. When my car enters in the first quadrant, you can see that all the LED lights glows with green color. That is all the 60 ratios that are sine theta, cosecant theta, tan theta, cot theta, they all glows with green light. This shows that all the 60 ratios are positive. You can see here when my car enters in the second quadrant, only sine theta and cosecant theta glows with green color and rest all the other 4 T ratios glows with red color. This means that the sine theta and cosecant theta they are positive and rest all the other 4 T ratios are negative. My car enters in the fourth quadrant. Here you can see red light glows. Tan theta and cot theta glows with green light. And tan theta and cot theta they all are positive and rest all other 4 T ratios are negative. Here you can see when my car enters in the fourth quadrant. Here only secant theta and cos theta glows with green light and rest of all other 4 T ratios glows with red light. This means that the secant theta and cos theta they are positive and rest all are negative. So this was all about my project, how sines of trigonometric ratios differ in different quadrants, from 0 degree to pi by 2, from pi by 2 to pi, from pi to 3 pi by 2 and then to 2 pi. My next project is types of functions. So this project can be used for teaching learning methods, for explaining the concepts of types of functions to the students. Like in the first row, we can see that the elements correspond for the value of x, a unique value of fx is required. Here you can see that only one element in fx value is left. This type of function is known as one and one function. We can see that more than one value of x, there exists a corresponding unique value in fx. Here you can see two elements in fx is left, but here you can see that a red one element is connected with two elements with x. This type of function is known as many one function. Third row, there is every value of x, there exists a unique value in fx. Here we can see that no value is left behind fx. This is the major difference between 1-1 functions and 1-1 and own 2 functions. Like in the fourth row, we can see that for every value of x, there exists a unique value in fx. Here we can see that no element is left in the fx value. This is the major difference between many one functions and many one and own two functions. Second project, types of function, which I have already explained to you. So thanks for watching my video patiently.